One of the points of using graphs is to try and identify some sort of a trend in the data, and with that in mind, Excel has given you the ability to analyze some of the graphs. So for example, we've got the graph here with months of the year, the product sales. And you can see this graph looks like there's some sort of a trend there. If you want to check whether the trend exists and what it looks like, we can go under layout. You'll see there's an analysis tool and there's a whole section on trend lines. My preferred method is choose the series you want to work with, right click on it, and you'll see over here it says add trend line. When we click on it, we get the following. You'll see when we get the trend line, we will be able to format the color, style and shadow, but the interesting one here is the trend line options. By default, you'll see it's set as linear, and you'll see on our graph we have a line which goes through the data and tries to explain the best fit for all these data items. You can, however, choose a whole range of trend lines. There's exponential, the linear we've discussed, the log, polynomial, power, and a moving average. Depending on what you choose, you have a couple of other options. The most typical in our experience is linear and moving average. Looking at some of the other options now, you'll notice that once you've chosen the trend or regression type, you can now decide, for example, on the trend line name. At the moment, it's called linear product A, but if you want, you can customize it. So that's whatever name you want it to be. You also have the ability to forecast. So based on this line, we can say, please forecast it, let's say, 6 periods further. What it does, it adjusts the chart so that the trend line continues for the next 6 months in this case. You can go backwards as well. Another thing you can do is you can display the equation that creates this line on the actual chart. If I click on it, you'll see the equation appears that explains that line. We can also display the R squared value, in this case 0.88. And as a rule of thumb, the closer it gets to 1, the better the fit. The closer it gets to 0, the worse the fit. The last item we haven't looked at yet is the set intercept. If I click on that, I'm going to say set the intercept, and by default it goes to 0. What it means is that line starts at 0, and this is the fit that will get us to this line. Generally speaking though, you should let Excel decide where the intercept should occur. So let's quickly just remove these. You'll see we've got the line. I'm just going to format it quickly so that the line color matches the color of the data. So that's fine. So you'll see blue bars in the blue line correspond. I'm now going to add product B in. So just grab that. So now you'll see we've got the red lines, and I can do the same thing with the red lines. Right click on it, say add a trend line. Maybe it's linear as well. I'm going to change the line color so it's red as well. When I say close, we've now got a graph with 2 products on it and the trend lines for both these products. So you can see that even though the red one seems to be high, it seems to be a bit of a downward trend or narrowing off of the growth, whereas the blue line, product A, seems to be growing at a little bit faster rate.